Okay, so I'll start a little demo now, and I will demonstrate to you how to prepare a pot. Let's take an example of this pot that I have here. One of the main things with containers is So one of the main things with any container is the drainage holes. These are the most important things that you need to check out for when you are choosing a container. If you don't have the drainage, so basically every time you water, the water is going to stay there and it will become a swamp, like a swampy situation, and your roots will rot in there. So check out that these holes are there. In some pots, you'll find some of the holes are flush when you put them down on the ground, and some are slightly raised on the side. That is also good because that means that it will not, the likelihood of these holes, and I'll hold this up closer, you can see here, this is slightly raised. The likelihood of this getting blocked is a lot less than this. So a few holes that are raised are helpful. The next thing is to make sure that these holes are protected. So we start by, you know, covering the bottom with a layer of broken pots. You know, you have broken terracotta pots, tiles, roof tiles. If you don't have any of that, stones, pebbles, the metal khadi that they use when they're making roads, if you get a handful of that, that also works. So I'm going to take a bunch of these stones that I've collected, and I'm going to layer the bottom here. Don't use very small stones so that they go and they lodge perfectly in the hole. Then they will not allow the water out, and in fact they'll do exactly the opposite of what you're aiming for. So here I have now put the stones in, and now I need to prepare my soil. So I'll show you briefly how you can make pretty good soil pretty fast. We are under lockdown conditions and perhaps immediately things may not be available, but I'll show you the ideal way that I usually prepare soil. We can use substitutes, and I believe that things will sort of be accessible soon, perhaps after the 20th, so you can go out and get some gardening material, especially since agricultural stuff will be available. I have here with me four pots. Obviously, I've chosen small sizes so that I can work with it, but you can... this is more as an indicator. We have four equal size pots. Basically, I need to have 50% soil. So I have two containers here that have soil in them. Just plain garden soil, whatever soil you have. If you are in Goa, you'll find sometimes the soil is very sandy. If you are elsewhere, you may find it's very clayey. I'll talk about how sandy and clayey differ in a moment. And here I have vermicompost with me. You can have, you can use compost, just plain compost instead of that. You can use cow dung instead of that. I use vermicompost because you know, it's a little richer in the nutrients. It's been through the intestines of an earthworm, and so it has the nutritive value is slightly higher. And here I have coco peat. Coco peat is basically the dust from the coconut husk once the fiber has been removed. And they sort of semi-decompose it so that it comes to a condition where it's more or less inert. Sometimes it may have salt that's washed off. And basically all this is going to mix together to form my soil. So once again, I have 50% garden soil, whatever soil you have. And I have 25% vermicompost, 25% coco peat. I'm going to mix these up right here. When you have garden soil, you'll find that there are pebbles in it. Sometimes they are pebbles, sometimes they are just clumps of soil. Once it's wet, it will break. But if it is a hard pebble, you can remove it. I'm going to add my coco peat, and I'm going to add vermicompost. Now, as I mix this, I'll tell you basically what the coco peat does. Coco peat has no nutrition. It is actually a soil conditioner. What it does is two things. It loosens up very clayey soil and creates great drainage. And at the same time, because it's organic matter or organic in nature, it has the ability to hold on to moisture. So it creates a situation where your soil retains moisture for a long time. So that's really what it does. Vermicompost is a dense nutrition. It's a balanced nutrition for your soil. It contains you know, enough of your nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium in varying quantities. And that really is what you're going to kick your soil with. And so here I have prepared my soil that I'm going to use. This is my standard go-to sort of recipe for making soil. Now, any big stones I'm going to remove. Most of them aren't even stones, they're just large. Okay. Once this is well mixed, I'm going to fill up my container with this. So here goes. Now, something I've noticed is often when people sort of prepare pots, they, for some reason, tend to fill a pot just halfway through. And don't do that. If you need less soil, use a smaller container, because if you plant something down there, it's going to be limited in the amount of sunlight that it gets. You want it to be at the surface. So if you think that either you have less soil or you think it doesn't need as much soil, use a smaller container, maybe 6 inches. This is, it's an 8-inch pot that I have here. If I take an 8-inch pot, I will make sure that I fill it just maybe an inch short of the top so that I can have my plant get a lot of good sunlight straight out. Now I'm short of the soil I prepared, but I have. Here. Now this is more or less filled till the top. It's not yet done. There's one last very crucial step that we must do to complete this is using dried leaves or what we call mulch. Now, mulch has several reasons to be there on your pot. Even in a garden, any garden bed should also have these dried leaves. The reason we use this is, for one, it reduces the amount of water you will need to add to your pot. Because the mulch layer is there, it sort of holds the moisture in. That's a big one. The other thing is that as you water, the soil in the pot tends to get compacted and even it tends to get, it sort of washes away through the holes. So having mulch, having a good, like at least a couple of inches in a pot ensures that the flow of water as you water your plants is slowed down and it doesn't wash away the soil. It prevents weeds from growing. You'll find that because of this covering, the weeds just get smothered, they don't grow. If it's cool, it will keep your soil warm. If it's warm, it will keep your soil cool. Eventually, this will also disintegrate and it will add more organic matter to your soil. So all in all, it's really one of the most important things to do when you're looking after your soil, whether it's in a garden bed or in pots. And another thing I should mention is that it creates the right environment for a lot of microbes to grow, which is very important. Good organic soil is living soil that is rich with microbes and earthworms and all kinds of things. So mulch creates, it helps that environment to be maintained. So now my pot is ready. I could either make a hole and put in a seed that I will sow, we'll get to that, or I could transplant something that I have ready, a seedling of, by just creating a bit of space and plonking it there in the middle.